with their eclectic bag of punk rock, trip-hop and candy pop, Sneaker Pimps are most definitely the pick and mix of 90s pop, with enough sugar and spice and all things nice to satisfy even the sweetest tooth.
So what exactly is a Sneaker Pimp?
Camp and the Beastie Boys interview that they did on an English music programme, and they had lots of friends on the payroll. And one guy they knew couldn't do anything musical, and so they sent him out into New York to find them old school trainers and called them their Sneaker Pimps.
How did the Sneaker Pimps originally come to be, come to pass?
Well, basically it was Liam and I doing obscure dance music for a few years, and then we got back to writing songs and we wanted a singer, so we went hunting for one. We found Kelly in Birmingham with a previous band.
Now, you've got your new single coming out soon. Tell us a bit more about that.
It's called Spin Spin Sugar. And it's quite a funky little number.
Is there like some kind of subtext to the song?
Sort of. Well, we've all got our own meaning to the songs, but to me it's sort of about this female robot that starts to malfunction and go crazy, which is sort of a parody of the subservient female through this sort of century. Take me
down, six underground. Now, a lot of your earlier stuff, the first two singles which you released, you did on this kind of limited edition kind of vibey thing. Why was that? Why did you decide to do that?
It's difficult to instantly become kind of popular, so it's good to push out some feelers and be a bit obscure in your first releases. So we didn't push the first two, we just let them do their own natural course. And then Six Underground was our first real single, which did very well.
Do you think it was maybe the strength of that particular song, or do you think that you actually had a big fan base that you'd built up over the earlier releases?
No, we sold it for 20p.
The album is called Becoming X. What does that mean? What's the X?
It can be anything, really. It's sort of a variation on the algebraic term X, meaning whatever you want it to mean. Also, it relates to Generation X. X is a blank to fill in. So, I mean, really, it's purposely ambiguous, like the songs are, that we try and let people use their imagination to make it more personal to them.